dear friends, I salute you. My name is Father Ponciano Ngondwe. I'm a Jesuit from Uganda, but working here at St. Joseph Catholic Parish in Kangemi. I'm in charge of taking care of all the development programs, the various projects that are under the parish. Under these projects are St. Joseph Upendo, Orphans and Vulnerable Children, that takes care of the orphan, vulnerable children, and children from the streets, where we bring them together, rehabilitate them, feed them, and then send them back to school so that they are able to attain a meaningful education for their future. We also have St. Joseph Uzima, who takes care of women's empowerment as a result of empowering them to be able to manage their lives, but also to run their families independently, to be able to avoid exploitation from unsuspecting persons who come thinking they are coming to help them. We also have other projects like the St. Joseph Technical Secondary School, which works very closely with other projects. St. Joseph Upendo, for example, supports children from the unit where you can see we are seated now to the primary school through to the technical secondary school until they are able to attain a meaningful, useful, future-oriented education. I sit here today to appreciate your support, to appreciate the partnership that you have held over the years. A partnership that started as friendship and has since grown into a partnership that has helped numerous people realize their dreams. At Upendo, we are able to look after different people, different children who are orphaned, vulnerable, and at a risk of going to the streets. And so with your support, we are able, first of all, to get these children out of the streets, educate them, give them values, take care of the medical needs, feed them, and then continue sending them to school, helping them to grow, not just as individuals, but also as God-loving persons. My dear friends, it is important that I appreciate your support, because your support is not small. It has transformed the lives of many children, as you might be able to listen, as you might be able to witness yourselves when you have the time to visit St. Joseph Upendo in Kangemi, Nairobi.
St. Joseph Upendo Orphans and Vulnerable Children's OVC Education Program was started by St. Joseph the Worker Catholic Parish, run by Jesuits in 1995. Upendo is a Swahili word meaning love, and the program aims at supporting street children, those likely to go to streets, orphaned, abandoned, sexually exploited, marginalized, and vulnerable children from Kangemi slums in Nairobi, Kenya. Upendo children are selected through the 31 small Christian communities of St. Joseph the Worker Parish in Kangemi to ensure that the child who joins the program is from a needy family and must be the neediest within that small Christian community area. And therefore, every year we select about 30 children to support. Since Upendo started, the program has helped over 600 children to integrate into the school system. Upendo aims at providing holistic support to orphaned and vulnerable children in Kangemi slums through various interventions. It provides quality education. Most of the families cannot afford to pay school fees or to buy the necessary materials such as school uniform and scholastic materials needed to attend school.
I have tracksuit. So what do we do? And you?
Even if they tell me like that.
What did they tell you?
They will buy for me a tracksuit.
Who will buy for you?
My mother.
Yeah. And then? You two, you talk to Father Ponciano.
This one didn't talk to us at once, so it's me alone.
You're in grade?
2.
And you?
2.
Both of you are in the same class?
2.
So Abigail, me, I don't have. We don't have. What do we do? You tell your grandmother you have informed me, but at the moment we don't have any trucks. So I will try and see. If we get sour, the same thing. I don't have. You know how much our trucks would cost? 1,600. Are you playing in the field?
Yeah, they always punish us.
Who punishes you?
The academic capabilities of the children are assessed through a basic oral and written evaluation. Based on performance, the children are then placed in suitable classes where they access daily class teachings, engage in sports, arts, and life skill activities. The first year is spent in the Upendo unit. At this unit, it works as a bridge from the street to school, and it rehabilitates children academically to ensure that they are ready to join a normal school. Once they join the primary school, they continue to be supported by sponsoring their school fees, providing necessary materials, and giving individual follow-up to their progress and needs to ensure they don't drop out of school. They are followed up through secondary school.
We offer psychosocial support to vulnerable children from Kangemi and vulnerabilities are ranging from children who are orphaned, partial orphans, children who have undergone several abuses, be it physical, sexual or emotional abuse. And we try every year, we take these children through the small Christian community of St. Joseph Parish and we integrate them to Upendo. And the first thing we address the issues, the children are overcoming the issues or the circumstances in which they were born in or in which they found themselves in. So in the first year we are offering psychosocial support through home visits and counseling, which is done by the teachers, the director and the social worker. And we are ensuring that this child is also getting the basic concepts in learning through reading and basic mathematics. We also offer medical support for those who are most needy and we do referrals in case we find that there are children who are not able to be supported within St. Joseph Health Center. Apart from just taking care of the child, we are also trying to empower the parents through various empowerment programs and seminars. At some extent, we even give a startup capital to parents to be able to start up businesses so that they can support the other children they have. Because you find that the children we have in Upendo, we are only able to support one per family. And the families, you find some have even 5, 6, or 7 children. Therefore, we are empowering this parent to also take care of the other children that they are having. We support children throughout, once they join the Upendo unit. We support them through the primary school and the secondary school. At the moment, we are supporting 150 children. 25 are at Upendo unit, which we hope by next year they will be joining the primary school. 104 children are at our primary school in St. Joseph Primary School and 18 are at St. Joseph Technical Secondary School, while 2 are in children's home and 1 who is in a special school. At Upendo unit, we are still rehabilitating the 25 children, helping them to overcome the challenges in which they have been facing. That includes providing psychosocial support through counseling sessions, listening to the children, visiting their families, understanding their backgrounds, and understanding the world of these children. And the biggest thing we want also to offer to the children and which we are offering is to enable them become children whom they are and enjoy being a child in Kangemi.
Upendo has improved access to healthcare system, including those living with HIV/AIDS. Physical and ecological conditions in urban slum settlements are particularly poor, exposing children to high levels of pollution and overcrowding. Children face an increased risk of environmental and contagious diseases. For children in Upendo unit, basic health care is provided. For the rest of the children in the program, medical support through networking with local health centers and dispensaries is provided to ensure the professional medical care and facilitation is given to get prescribed medicines and further treatment to hospitals are accessible to them. Upendo also provides nutritional support. Majority of the beneficiaries live in harsh poverty conditions, and most of them are only able to afford one meal per day, or sometimes no meal at all. This is a real situation which does not only affect Upendo beneficiaries, but most people living within Kangemi slum. The program provides breakfast and a balanced lunch to the children. For severe malnutrition and cases of HIV/AIDS, special diets are also facilitated. Upendo also provides psychosocial support. Many children face trauma situations because of the poor conditions they live in and the situations they have to face at an early age, such as gender-based violence, sexual violence, domestic violence. This poses risks such as early pregnancy and childbearing and exposure to sexually transmitted infections. Individual and group counseling sessions are conducted by the social worker and the teacher to address the psychological needs of the children. Cases requiring extended attention are facilitated through linkage with required external professional services. The social worker carries out regular home visits and interviews with the children to assess any further issues or situations that need to be addressed. Parents and guardians have also empowerment programs. The program empowers the parents with suitable means of managing their families through providing trainings on better financial management for low-income earners, savings in self-help groups, as well as income-generating activities and skills training. This leads to improved survival skills as well as capacities for growth. To facilitate all these activities, we depend on our partners, supporters, and local community. We say a big thank you for enabling us to educate the children in Kangemi.
My name is Jacqueline Barongo. I'm a teacher at Upendo, St. Joseph. I've been working with the children for the previous years and even this year. The children we receive from the community have different challenges, and the program is really trying to get them out of the challenges, most of them, though some becomes a challenge because of sometimes lack of funds. The children, when we receive them from the community, some of them are having low self-esteem, some are malnourished, and some of them have health problems. The children I have currently had a problem of reading, understanding, and even speaking English. They were having a lot of fear, most of them, when they came. But since we are closely monitoring them and giving them love that they lack from the community, the families where they come from, their self-esteem is coming up. They are now confident. They can speak out whatever they have, what they want. Even their learning has improved. Most of them are able to read, they can write compositions, they speak good English.
My name is Rita Moni, I am 10 years old. I learn at St. Joseph Nasarian Primary School. I am in class 5M. Thank you for the tender care that you cared for us.
My name is Joseph Kani. I come from St. Joseph Local Primary School. I am in standard 5M. Continue praying for you and your family. May you have a blessed day and be blessed by our mighty God. Thank you.
Good afternoon, good evening, good morning. My name is Father Binamungu Faustin Mukasa. I am the father in charge of St. Joseph the Worker Parish, Kangemi. I'm glad to be talking about our partnership with St. Lawrence in Flowing. I came here at this parish in 2016, in February 2016. I found already this partnership going on. And actually, I was a beneficiary of the exchange program immediately after my arrival, because a few months after my arrival, I was fortunate to go to Flawil together with the other parishioners of this parish for a visit. I want really to thank both our parishes, especially Flawil, for this partnership, which has greatly improved our dimension of faith in the parish. I understand that this partnership started in the 90s, so it is really impressive to see that for all these years, actually for decades, this partnership has continued, and it has continued well. We've had quite a number of activities taking place. Exchange programs are only part of these activities, but the exchange program per se is not the only is not just for the sake of exchange. Through this exchange program, we are able to learn about one another. We get the opportunity to encourage each other's faith as parishes, because we all believe in the same Jesus Christ. He's the one who has brought us together. And in this partnership, we have been able also to benefit mutually, socially, and in other ways. St. Joseph the Worker particularly, we have been able to receive quite a number of supports from Flawil, support for our church, physical construction of the church, but even most recently, for which I would like even to thank Flawil, we received support, financial support for our vulnerable children at Upendo. This support has gone into supporting the nutrition for the children, and then it has offered psychosocial support. It has helped us to purchase some kitchen equipment, and it is also part of it will help to contribute towards the construction of a new kitchen in order to address some environmental issues, especially given the fact that the kitchen we have right now also emits a lot of smoke. The support also is going to scholastic material to help the children who come actually from families which are unfortunate and vulnerable. So, this year we have five members of our parish visiting Flawil once again, and this is just an expression of the appreciation of this partnership, and we hope this partnership will continue for the mutual benefit of both parishes. We pray that God may continue to sustain our partnership, but more especially sustain the faith which makes this partnership meaningful. Thank you very much.
Friends, I'm grateful for all that you've been doing for us, for all the friendship, the commitment, and the partnership. And I'm very sure that with your support, with this friendship, we shall take our children, we shall help our children attain their dreams. In a special way, allow me to thank you again for the support you gave us last year, a support that helped us, one, to improve our kitchen, where we are now going to improvise, build a good kitchen that will, first of all, be eco-friendly, less carbon, but also will create more space to allow our students, our children, learn in a more student-friendly, study-friendly environment. I thank you for that, and I invite you, as you wish, and as you get time, to visit us here at St. Joseph.